Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about the semi-empirical binding energy or mass formula. In the previous video we have discussed the nuclear model, in which I discussed the liquid drop model, some similarity about the liquid drop and nucleus. So let's start the video. Semi-empirical binding energy or mass formula. The scientist C.B. Weizsäcker, a German physicist, proposed the following semi-empirical formula for nuclear binding energy in MeV for the nucleus. That is, binding energy equal to Av times A, this is mass number, minus As, this is surface constant, A to the power 2 by 3 minus Ac, Coulomb constant, Zz minus 1 upon A to the power 1 by 3, माइनस ए एन ए माइनस टू जेड का होल स्क्वायर अपॉन ए प्लस माइनस जीरो डेल अपॉन ए टू द पावर थ्री बाई फोर विद द कॉन्स्टेंट्स हैविंग द वैल्यू ए वी इक्वल 15.75 ए एस इक्वल टू 17.80 ए सी इक्वल 0.71 ए एन इक्वल टू 22.7 एंड डेल इक्वल 33.6 ऑल आर इन एम ई वी दिस वैल्यूज आर नॉट एब्सोल्यूट other sets values are also possible. So here the first term is volume term, volume energy, and this term is surface energy, and this is a Coulomb energy term, and this is asymmetry energy, and this is pairing energy. So first we discuss the volume energy. So the first term Av equal Av into A is the volume effect, representing the volume energy of all nucleons. The more the total number of nucleons, more difficult it to become to remove an individual nucleon. तो nucleons जितना ज़्यादा होंगे उतना ही difficult होगा individual nucleons को remove करने के लिए from the nucleus. Since the nuclear density is nearly constant, the nuclear mass is proportional to nuclear volume, which is again proportional to r to the power 3. So since r proportional to a to the power 1 by 3, so we can write as r q proportional to a. So the volume energy Ev is directly proportional to a. Clear? This is 4 by 3 pi r q. Volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. And this rq is directly proportional to A. So this volume energy is directly proportional to A. So this gives Av equal Av into A. This energy corresponds to the amount of heat energy, that is heat of vaporization, required to transform a liquid to its vapor state, being proportional to the mass of the liquid. Now surface energy, the second term, that is Es equal to As e to the power 2 by 3, is the surface effect, which is similar to the surface tension in the liquid. Like the molecules on the surface of a liquid, the nucleons at the surface of a nucleus are not completely surrounded by other nucleons. It results in reducing the total binding energy due to nucleons on the surface. And this correction due to surface energy Es, which is proportional to surface area of the nucleus. So this factor is comes from the surface tension, like surface tension in liquid. So this, and this is equal to 4 pi r square. So Es is directly proportional to r square, and this r is proportional to a to the power 1 by 3, so r square is a to the power 2 by 3. If r is proportional to 1 by 3, r square is proportional to 2 by 3, a to the power 2 by 3. So this gives Es equal to As a to the power 2 by 3. Clear? Now Coulomb energy. The third term, Ec, is the Coulomb interaction, electrostatic repulsion between the charged particles in the nucleus. Since these particles, P each charged particle repulses all the other charged particle, this term would directly proportional to the possible number of combinations for a given proton numbers, which is Zn-1/2. The energy of interaction between proton is again inversely proportional to the distance of the separation r. So the energy associated with Coulomb reaction is this much, Ec equal to k Zz-1/r, and which is equal to Ac, this is constant, Zz-1/(a^3), where Ac equal 3/5 into E square 4π ε₀ R naught. Binding energy decreases due to Coulomb terms. Now the fourth part is asymmetry energy, and this term originates from the symmetry between the number of protons and the number of neutrons in the nucleus. Nuclear data for stable nuclei indicate that for lighter nuclei, the number of protons is almost equal to that of the neutrons, that is n equal to z. But as A increases, the symmetry of proton and neutron number is lost. As we know that earlier the number of proton and neutrons are always same, but as A increases, the symmetry of proton and neutron number is lost, and the number of neutron exceeds that the proton to maintain the nuclear stability. So जैसे जैसे हम mass number बढ़ाते जाते हैं, number of neutron exceed कर जाता है proton से nuclear stability को maintain करने के लिए, and this excess of neutron over protons, that is n minus z, is the measure of the symmetry, asymmetry, and it decreases the stability or the binding energy of the medium or heavy nuclei. So this also decreasing the binding energy. So Ea is proportional to n minus z, and Ea is directly proportional to n minus z upon A. So this energy increases with n minus z and decreases with mass number. So Ea is equal to An, which is a constant, n minus z ka whole square upon A. So combining these two, we get this. And then after putting this value, which is n equal to A minus z, so this becomes n equal A minus z. So this becomes An A minus 2z whole square upon A. Now the fifth term, that is the last term, is the pairing energy. A pure collective terms is called the pairing energy, EP, and this is equal to plus minus 0 del upon a^3/4, and this is the table. So we can find this value, find the value of EP with this table. So if z is even, n is even, so A is even. In this case del is equal to 34 and EP equal to del upon a^3/4. And if z is even, n is odd, then A is odd, then in this case del is 0 and this is 0. Similarly, if number of proton is odd, number of neutron is even, then the mass number is odd, and this gives also del 0 and EP 0. If both odd, the number of proton and neutron, then mass number A is even, and this gives the value of del is 35 and EP is minus del upon a^3/4. So these all the terms gives the binding energy, binding fraction, or the binding energy per nucleon, that is FB equal binding energy upon A equal AB minus AS upon a^1/3 minus AC Zz-1/4/3 minus AN A minus 2Z ka whole square upon A square plus minus, this is last term, pairing, del upon a to the power 7 by 4. So this is the expression which given by Wishacker, and this is all about for today. Thanks for watching video. Thank you.